Thank Mitabah! Oh, finally then, the three bells sang! Disciples come, I hear travelers approaching my temple, carrying new treasures! I cannot see you, but I recognize your odor! You are back? It must be you who took that Kasaya! Now give it back! Terrible boy! The Tamu monk and his disciples! curse you! Without his soul. No, stop, stop, stop! His coercion, Bobo. Next time, leave it! Just leave it! Stop the fire!
Fireproof mantle. The great sage borrowed it from Virapaksa. How did it end up here? You must have freed that miserable soul. Oh, such is his end. A tragedy prologued by a single glance. It's getting late. Let's hurry up the mountain.
Come to the wrong place. Thank you. first.
Five hundred years. I have rebuilt the temple. Now it's grander in scope. All those monks consumed by the fire turned to wandering ghosts roaming in Black Wind Mountain. It was I who granted them eternal repose. I have even restored the charred scriptures, piece by piece. But oh yes, I always knew. One day you shall return! That's a familiar... Burn the temple down! Have some cheap tricks. Meet me at the summit if you dare!
The spell he just cast may appear intricate, but it's not hard to learn. That Black Bear's expertise is lacking. Serving Guan Yin didn't help him much. But what he left here could surely help us. Consider today your lucky day. Focus and disperse, illusions traverse. You still have a lot to learn, but give yourself the time you need.
Coming for our master? Think again!
Ahead is a treacherous path, young one. Don't forget the spell you just learned.
Oh!
is to reward whoever kills the mountain.
He once told me, out of sight, out of mind is a fool's task. Seeing but seeing through is what wise men do. But didn't he turn mad by what he saw too? Cunning wretch! We'll spare your sorry life for today! Fortune is no longer on your side! No one will come to your aid. All I need is to take it elsewhere and rebuild everything anew! Great the sage! Pardon me, young sage! Mercy, young sage, have mercy! I was just a pawn of the Celestial Court. If given a choice, who dared to challenge the mighty wrecker of the Celestial Palace?
His words ring true. No matter how daring he was, he had not the nerve to harm the great sage. There must be someone else pulling all the strings.
Exactly, and this thing is eerie. I had no idea how to make use of its power. Except to enshrine it up there, tricking lesser Yaoguais into offerings. If you pardon me, I'll go back to Guanyin to atone for my actions and be put back on the encaging band. You will never see me out there anymore.
Oh, ignore his nonsense. Go now, little monkey. Go and retrieve the great sage's relic.
百卷轻，千般缘，色与空，弹指间，轮回路，又万次劫，求不得，闭上眼，一生功名忙如烟，浮沉落花断不绝。
口中念，心中念，现世报却方便。修行路无明尽，凡懂事莫等闲。一生功名轻如烟，最后人无再少年，最是烟火。
Master, it still puzzles me. A monk's lust for gold should be quelled. Why does Elder Jinche still cling to that one Kasaya?
Bereft of that Kasaya, how shall they show the world their ties are cut and their lust is quelled?
Across streams, over hills, and through the black wind your blood has spilled. Wolves howl, snakes wind, flames lick, and the smoke blinds. Stumble on the lesser, lame, crash before their betters, shame. With such clumsiness, what destiny do you claim? As the small fish catches its prey, the bigger lurks behind. Who is the bigger fish? I can't see it. As for the prey and the small fish, they are swimming everywhere. In his last life, the monk was Jinchanzu, the second disciple to Buddha in the West. Yet his arrogance led him to disregard the Dharma teachings, and as a result, the Buddha cast him down to the mortal realm. He was destined to face 81 trials throughout his journey. The fire for that Kasaya was merely the 11th. Which deities do most abound upon the earth? The keepers, surely. Though humble in rank, nothing in the mortal world escapes their eyes. You'd be wise not to spurn their kind, for who knows what powers stand behind them. A mere human, blessed with a lifespan nearing 3 centuries, yet he was never sated. He just had to seize that one Kasaya. Centuries of devotion, undone by a moment's greed. In the end, a lost soul became him. How pathetic. Thank you.
A fine guardian for Guan Yin he could have been. Yet he came back here to daydream immortality. Sadly, he had the greed, but lacked the pluck. He could fool his followers, but not himself. His destiny was sealed the moment he donned that band.